Hello, warriors! Are you ready to get free? Do you want to get free? Now you have to pay attention for what I'm about to say. Let's continue with my book, The Lazarus Effect, the chapter Subliminal Messages. Now we are at part 2, the sex propaganda. Pay attention, motherfucker! Maybe it is for you. Pay attention. Okay, let's debunk the sex propaganda. Procreating is the driving force behind all human accomplishments. Think about the adventures and trials of the hunter just to bring back her love some fresh game. Think about the mayhem and chaos caused by kings who went to war because of a woman. Think about the hard work put in by a lumberjack just to buy a little present to impress his woman of desire. All the effort man put forth is aimed for procreation, and because the act of sex gives as such a rush, you are easily get enslaved by it. I urge you, reader X, to only engage in sexual act if you are actually procreating. As a man who is just at his beginning of his quest, I advise you to practice celibacy, and furthermore stop releasing your semen. Semen retention is practiced for thousands of years by sages, by humanists, by humanity's biggest thinkers like Tesla, and by the great warriors of our times like Tyson and Ali. The success of these legends may be accredited to their sexual discipline. The man who can control his sexual drive by retaining his semen will get hold of a superpower, the iron will. For thousands of years, majority of men enjoyed this superpower until technology caught us all off guard. Technology made sex a casual thing. The hookup culture, internet pornography, and not least advertising made men thinking about sex 24/7. Technology also made it easier for men to have sex or to release his semen by casual sex or masturbation. No more hunting needed, no more war needed, and no more work is needed for the average man to indulge in the sexual act. Very interesting. Among all the activities, the worst for a young man is to get addicted to pornography. A research stated that porn is 10 times more addictive than cocaine, which makes it extremely hard to quit. My friend, society made you believe it's okay to let some steam off. Some doctors even stated that masturbation prevents prostate inflammation and cancer, which is a lot of bullshit. It is all bullshit. If you are hooked on porn, and almost masturbation, you must try at once to recover. Ever wonder why you are always tired, without vitality, anxious, depressed, craving junk food, unfocused, always catching a cold, sleeping for 10, 12, 14 hours a day, having bad skin, bad teeth, weak vision, weak muscular endurance, weak skeletal system, low libido, and an overall defeated aura around you? Well, you are releasing your semen left and right. That's why your semen is full of nutrients, minerals, proteins, vitamins, and all of the necessary things to create life. Think about it. How much energy and sacrifice does the body put in for you to be the health of the life-creating entity that you are? Your subconscious mind not know you are watching photos, videos, or imagining having sex. All it knows that you had sex with the most beautiful women. there are, you successfully procreated, released your semen, and now it is making you take a break and eat until you recover. The brain is a very sophisticated mechanism, but once it it knows that you achieved a very important objective like procreation, it will shut down, let's say, half of its capabilities. It doesn't know if the procreation actually was taking place or it was only in your fucking mind. Okay. Now imagine doing this several times a day, a couple dozen times per week. You will get in no time a fat, lazy motherfucker who is not motivated to do anything. And forget about chasing your dreams. It is a miracle you have woke up from your fucking bed. Reader X, the matrix of consumerism will attack every day this basic human instinct, procreation. Every single day from this addiction, I advise you as a friend to have a better plan ready. From the minute you wake up until you go to bed, you will need to occupy your mental space with the things that will make your ultimate goal get closer to you. You need to be on your guard wherever you go, whenever you surf social media, YouTube videos. Be careful for the triggers, for the tension thoughts and the energy vampires. I encourage you to take up this habit of restoration and preservation, increased energy, high vitality and motivation, faster muscle recovery, dense bones, increased posture, confidence, assertiveness, leadership and conquering aura. On top of all this, my friend, women will adore you and want to be around you all day, which is what you have wanted in the first place. Be careful not to waste your newfound energy on some casual sexual encounters. Get yourself a relationship with a woman who is ready to climb a mountain with you, and after that you can procreate or have an intimate relationship without losing control of your sexual discipline. If you are an addict for a long time, please seek help or get involved in a program that will help you fight this addiction. Read everything you can on the subject and apply the gems from this book, like having set a goal, schedule and a clear desire to become free of this addiction. Avoid watching movies, videos and social media until you can get a sense of control on this issue. Depending on how many years were you affected by this socially accepted virus, it will take you some time to defeat this addiction. Reading this book and applying my suggestion will be a great start. I wish all the best, my friend, and may you take control of this superpower called semen retention. If you have any questions, if you think I can help you, please comment me down below and I try to answer as fast as I can. You're not alone in this. If you are at the beginning of your journey, there will be many hard days, but we are many who are still fighting the good fight, and we are hoping you join us to fight this evil system. Stay strong.